Ask the Doctor segment is all about irregular heartbeats and a treatment for AFib that's called Watchman. I'm joined by Dr. Sahil Attawala from Princeton Baptist to take your calls. Here's the number, 741-9272, 741-9272, to ask the doctor your questions. First of all, let's give folks some of the basics. AFib is what? Is it just an irregular heartbeat?
Correct, yeah, so it's an irregular heartbeat that comes from the top left part of the heart. It in of itself is not a dangerous or life-threatening heart rhythm, but people certainly do feel bad when they're in it. The most dangerous thing about the rhythm itself is the risk of you having a stroke. The reason why that happens is the top of the heart is going so fast that blood starts pooling in that part of the heart, and whenever blood pools anywhere, that's where it can form blood clots. And those blood clots, when they dislodge, they can travel to any part of the body. The part that's the most dangerous is when it can travel to the brain, and that's how a stroke can happen when someone has AFib.
Okay, so that's the problem we're talking about.
Exactly.
We have our first caller. Charlotte, what is your question for the doctor?
Yes, I have a question about the Watchman that you mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
Is it a procedure or what?
Yeah, so it's a procedure that we can do, and often in patients who have problem being on a blood thinner. So typically the way that we treat or reduce the risk of you having a stroke is by putting you on a blood thinner. Now, you know, obviously there's risk from being on a blood thinner. A lot of times people can have bleeding problems when they're on the blood thinner. So simply stopping the blood thinner is oftentimes not the right answer because at that point you're left with having the risk for a stroke. So what we can do in the Watchman procedure is it's a minimally invasive procedure that's done through a catheter that's inserted through a vein in the leg, similar to a heart catheterization. And then the majority of the blood clots that form in the heart relating to AFib are in an area of the heart called the left atrial appendage. So the Watchman procedure involves putting a plug into that part of the heart so that blood can't enter in and can't leave. And eventually, once the device itself is completely healed over, the patient can be safely taken off of the blood thinner.
Okay, so a good explanation of Watchman. We have another caller, Mitchell. What is your question?
I've been in AFib for 6 years or so, and they've tried to shock me three times back into rhythm, but it won't stay. Mm-hmm. And the doctor which I go to is at Princeton, and he has mentioned ablation, but never has followed through with it. And I just wonder if this would be anything helpful to me, because I am so tired, I can't hardly do anything.
Mm-hmm. So ablation.
Yeah. So that's a very common question that we get. Is, you know, when is the right time to do an ablation? Certainly it's anytime that you have symptoms related to AFib that aren't controlled with medicines, or, you know, we are having a hard time getting you back into normal rhythm with doing the shock procedure, the cardioversion that you had mentioned, it's appropriate to do an ablation. Currently, based on the recommendations that we have, it's not recommended to do the ablation procedure simply to get off of the blood thinner. It would be done mainly just to control and improve your symptoms. So if certainly, you know, you have symptoms of tiredness, fatigue, or you're getting out of breath, or if your heart races, those are the symptoms that we can help correct with an ablation procedure.
All right. Dr. Attawala, thanks very much for being with us. We appreciate you explaining Watchman and some of these treatments that people need to check with their own doctors, correct?
Absolutely.
All right.